Pour un jour de finale, finale inattendue d'ailleurs. Ça vous plaît ce que vous avez vu ou pas? Non, ça vous plaît ou pas? Aurélien Lafargue, designer digital et le maître de la scénographie cette année, merci à lui, ses équipes et à Mourad, au son! Merci à eux, merci à la cité également d'avoir accueilli cet événement hybride, artistique et sportif. Je voudrais qu'on fasse aussi un gros big up à l'un des principaux acteurs de ce tournoi. Je suis sûr que j'ai pas besoin de dire sa fonction. François Lejeune! Est-ce que vous croyez qu'on va redevenir événement sportif de l'année en Loire-Atlantique? Est-ce que vous croyez? Ouais, moi je le sens bien ça. Bon, il y a un gros programme qui nous attend avec les finales, comme je le disais. Finale femme pour commencer, finale homme avec notre Frenchie tenant du titre qui a créé l'exploit hier. On va y venir. Je vais poursuivre un petit peu les remerciements puisque j'ai vu encore de nombreux partenaires qui apparaissent sous les affiches du génial Michel Bouvet, l'affichiste, qu'on peut aussi applaudir pour ses œuvres d'art. Mais aussi ces entreprises, ces institutionnels qui nous font le plaisir de nous faire confiance. Sans vous, sans eux, on n'est rien du tout. Applaudissez-vous, applaudissez-les. C'est un régal de remplir la salle, c'est un régal. Je ne peux pas savoir. Un petit aparté supplémentaire, vous verrez qu'on est en jour de finale, donc un peu protocolaire. Il y aura des remises de prix, des petites surprises tout au long de la journée. Mais je voudrais également qu'on salue la présence de la Fédération Française de Squash avec Monsieur le Président qui est là, qui va se lever, Monsieur Jacques Fontaine, ainsi que ses deux vice-présidents, Monsieur Serge Viau, le local, et Monsieur Fontanon. Merci à eux d'être là encore une fois et de voir que l'événement devient de plus en plus dingue. Allez, vous êtes chaud ou pas? Vous êtes chaud ou pas? Allez, on va accueillir tout d'abord l'une des surprises de ce tournoi. Elle a fait un match assez exceptionnel hier. On a eu du tie-break, ça a duré plus d'une heure. Vraiment un match entre compatriotes qui a tenu toutes ses promesses. Elle a sorti l'une des grandes surprises également du tournoi. Tête de série 6, elle a 26 ans, à son meilleur classement. 98e joueuse mondiale. Elle est d'ailleurs récemment finaliste de l'Open de Belfast, où elle avait perdu contre Laura Pomportes, d'ailleurs, qui a également perdu hier, notre Française. Vous allez voir, elle est adorable, des yeux rieurs, elle est ravie d'être là. Rachel Chadwick!
We have the technology.
Face à elle, l'une des plus jeunes. Allez, je vais pas mentir, je vais dire que je m'y attendais un petit peu, mais l'une des plus jeunes, elle nous vient d'Égypte. Elle parle très très bien français, elle comprend tout ce que je dis et elle comprend également tout ce que vous dites. C'est un régal d'avoir des Égyptiens francophones et de les voir ici. On adore les recevoir. 18 ans, 70e joueuse mondiale, un gros talent, elle est très très prometteuse, meilleur classement 61e. Allez, vous êtes prêts ? Anna Ramadan ! Je rappelle que c'est un jour de finale et que nous attendons l'une des surprises tout à l'heure, comme je le disais, après ce très beau match pour la première édition d'un tournoi féminin qui nous ont rejoints ici sur le court vitré en demi-finale. Je rappelle la présence exceptionnelle pour un Open à $25,000 de prize money de Squash TV. On est en
direct. Welcome to the Open International de Squash de Nantes 2016. We're live for finals day. And the first match of today's play involves Hannah Ramadan, the number 3 seed, the 18-year-old from Alexandria, taking on Rachel Chadwick, the 26-year-old, number 6 seed from Omnipia. And then we have Gregoire Marsh, the number 4 seed, taking on Chris Simpson, the number 2 seed afterwards. So Rachel Chadwick came through a brutal 5-setter with Julianne Courtis. Yesterday went all the way to the wire, four games of tie breaks, managing to just squeeze it out 11-9 in the fifth. So a very tough match for her, and in comparison, Ramadan, after a slightly shaky first part of the first game, managed to sweep through Laura Pompoutez of France, three games to love. Very, very aggressive player, this young Egyptian lady. I'm Joe Barrington, and joining me for both these finals today, we have the ex-PSA World Tour player, Simon Hirsch.
Good afternoon, Joey.
Well, Parky, recovery properties, what do you think for Rachel Chadwick?
Well, I don't think she's going to have too many problems. I think she might be a little bit sore, but she looks like a good athlete. Seen her in the previous match, but it is going to be a little bit tough. She plays a fast pace, young Ramadan. Just likes to take the ball early, hit the ball quite ferociously, so it'll be interesting to see how Chadwick backs up, really.
Looking forward to your expert comments, Parky, in this women's final. According to a few people, one person on social media, you've got no idea.
That's probably about right.
So that's nice to know. We're just talking, just going on that point slightly, we're talking about the women's game and how some of the events, particularly at the top level, the equal parity of prize money. Got the comparison of the tours where the women's tour, not sure how many are 100% of the time, but with the increase in prize money, which is certainly happening, it certainly gives the ladies an incentive to kind of try and get into top 16 in the world, where they can actually start to make a pretty decent living. I mean, it's down to obviously private sponsors as well, that can help hugely. As a former player, you know all about that, but it certainly gives them an incentive to really push hard. I mean, there's about 500 players on the PSA Men's World Tour. I think it's around about 220 on the women, but I'm sure it will start to grow.
Yeah, it's going in the right direction, and the carrot is definitely there, isn't it, for men and women. It's tough for these girls. This is a 5K event. Very tough flow down the rankings, but this is your apprenticeship, isn't it, as you go along, and that is the target, I would imagine, for, you know, you might really not aim for the very top echelons of the game.
Completely. It's the whole motivation to get involved in world-class sport, but talking with the organisers about next year,
this ladies' tournament and looking to bring it into parity with the men's. So an increase in the winners would be quite substantial, from 5k to 25 or even a bit bigger.
Well, that would be fantastic and could even coax Camille Serm into playing the event, which is what they would want, obviously, being the star player. Maybe even Omar.
He's a little bit bigger for men, possibly. Obviously, it would have to be quite considerably larger to entice Gregory Gaultier, sadly. But they've got Lucas Serm and Mathieu Castagnier that could well be fronting up.
Maybe have to think about different scheduling because the European Championships was this week, wasn't it?
I mean, just what we've talked about from there, Parky, which I think is pretty reasonable, what we talked about. I still don't think you've got any idea.
I know you don't. I've been spending the whole week with you, about
no idea,
4 inches away from your head when I wake up in the morning.
That's
just
nice.
Relaxing.
Very relaxing. Hence the pillow over my head.
I was just about to point that out. But I have been told on many occasions that I have absolutely no idea, so used to it.
It can always be done on social media. Chadwick will really need to have a good strength around the middle. She doesn't want to start to get on the back foot because the younger Egyptian does hit the ball very, very aggressively and hard, as we say. She's unrelenting, as a lot of these Egyptian ladies are playing. So Rachel Chadwick needs to try to hold the middle. She's got a decent presence. We saw actually with the line and length of
women's final match,
Rachel
Chadwick of England to serve Anna Ramadan
of corner. She's got quite a big swing in the back corner, Ramadan. She doesn't adjust it that much and she gets caught up. So the back corner is certainly an area that can cause some issues for the Egyptian if Rachel Chadwick can get that good line and length and width.
Yeah, certainly the back left, I think,
and
is a bit of an issue initially for Ramadan. I think utilising the lob would be a good tactic as well here and there for Chadwick, trying to get the ball nice and high and in the back corners away from the volley.
Down.
It's a little bit careless there.
True love.
Just getting rid of a few nerves here in this final.
And
she's
out.
Kind of one, two. Sometimes, Chadwick. You don't think she's going to get there, and then she just puts in a late lunge and a decent kind of flick. A little bit laboured there, I think.
And out.
Going in on that
three,
left
one.
Foot, catching the sidewall.
Down and out, 2-3.
That's a good whip from Chadwick.
Out and out, 4-2.
Well, Ramadan with a slightly brighter start here. Timing the ball. Oh, that's a little bit laboured as well. There must be a little bit of residual soreness
for
Chadwick after her marathon match yesterday. Hopefully she can get rid of that quite quickly.
Get up.
Well, that helps.
And out.
Don't knock it. 3-5. David Palmer won a British Open on that shot against James Wilstrup.
Certainly did. Heartbreaking for Wilstrup.
Oh, that was in Liverpool, wasn't it?
Certainly was.
Down. 4-5.
The crowd absolutely loved the Battle of the English Ladies last night. I mean, it was such a good promotion for the women's game, the way that from literally the first serve they were knocking 7 bells out of each other. So, so competitive, running down absolutely everything on the lower tier. And then I hope physically that Rachel Chadwick can back up and make a real match of
decision
this final
Ramadan.
With Hannah Ramadan.
Stroke to Ramadan. And
she's done well really
6-5.
Here to remain in touch, because she's not. Ramadan's been clearly the better player at the beginning of this final. Pick up. Yeah, it was fantastic to see them work so hard.
7-5.
Great to see them move up the ranks in future years.
And out. 6-7.
Well, that's tight work from Chadwick. That's the kind of thing she needs to do. That backhand, keep trying to pressure that area.
Yeah, it's a controlled, powerful line. It's she's not trying to hack the ball to length. It's a good bit of control and attention to detail. Again, nice and wide. She is using that front wall well. There you go, that's the low line. She's mixing the paces up. That's brilliant.
Very good.
Chadwick. That was a really intelligent, classy rally from Rachel Chadwick.
Left side.
Positive on the volley.
Sorry. Right side. 8-7.
She's not letting Ramadan get in front of her here. So 8-7 in this first game. And there's the ace. We see so many aces on this
seven.
Court. It's becoming quite popular in this event, the old squash serving ace. You know.
And Dara Sabi wasn't too happy with some of the bounces yesterday.
But she's
and
can't
out
be complacent.
8-9.
Because the Egyptian girl will start to up her game in response. She has to hit. Good work from Chadwick, and that is superb.
It is, but she's going to call. She's going to appeal on that pickup. It was a little bit. I was a little bit unsure.
We are not sure. Yes, let.
Oh, that's a shame for Chadwick.
On the left side, we are not sure on the on your pickup. Yes,
just
let.
Didn't look
8-9.
That clean. I mean, she may have got it first bounce.
She definitely got
she
it
did.
First bounce.
We are not sure.
Just,
yes, let.
When we first saw it, it looked like a bit of a scramble.
Pick
not
up.
Sure.
Your pickup.
Referee's saying about the pickup, obviously. I thought that was absolutely fine.
Yeah, the slow-mo confirmed it was good. So,
it's a bit annoying for Chadwick. She's got to back on here. Definitely getting a lot of success in that backhand back corner. I mean, she's had a couple of
and out,
slightly fortunate bounces.
10, 8,
but Ramadan, when
Kemble.
She lets the ball go past the racket into this side, she doesn't shorten a swing at all. And she gets herself in a lot of trouble. So she needs to keep using back corners well. Chadwick, two game balls.
Not up. Thank
well,
you.
It was a little bit early call. I mean, it was not up in the end
and
from Chadwick,
out,
but the
9,
referee
10,
was
Kemble.
Full start by him. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, again, just slightly laboured up to that boast, but she's still the game ball, Chadwick.
She's just looking back at Ramadan.
10 all.
She's been shut out on the volley.
By 2 points.
It was a weak ball. She took it out there, just slightly moved across. But 10 all. She needs to
pushing up on that tee line. She is remotely in trouble at the front. She has to use height. Too dangerous to play counter drop against Ramadan if you're late on the ball.
11-10, game ball.
Yeah, that's when her movement's going to be exposed, isn't it? And I do still think she's struggling a little bit. Not moving as freely as she was yesterday, quite understandably.
Frustrating for Chadwick, just slightly laboured into the front.
Ramadan,
it was Ramadan
one game too long.
Sniffed the opportunities, taking it first time. So an eventful first game, another tie break.
Bon, comme je vous disais,
Ramadan
vous avez les écrans
takes it. She leads one game to love.
Yeah, I thought Rachel Chadwick did really well here because she's obviously struggling a bit from yesterday. She played good line and length, didn't put herself in too many awkward positions. And as you said, Joey, she had to be careful to the front of the court because Ramadan is so dangerous there if you give her time. And she did actually try to get her in the back left a few times, got some dividend there. But Ramadan started playing a lot more positive just at the latter stages and exposed the movement of Chadwick. Ramadan, one love up. So Rachel Chadwick, a bit of work to do here against Ramadan. Ramadan, the more sprightly of the two at present. That's good work, tight work from Chadwick. That's what she needs to do, really. Try to keep her younger opponent behind her. Take the chances there. That's a good hit. That's a very good hit. She's not happy there. Has a little look at the referee about the pickup. I think just from that it looked good, but not conclusive. Well, she really likes that shot. Normally, she played a lot of winners with that forehand boast and on the volley yesterday. Just clipping the tin there. She's a bit of a steam train, isn't she, Hannah Ramadan? She just keeps going. It's hard. She's hard to stop.
Yeah, once she gets on that roll.
Three.
I mean, it was pretty crucial for Chadwick to have tried to take that first game.
Yeah, she really needed that first.
Left side, 4-2, and out. Decision, Chadwick. No let. 5-2.
Yeah, she's has to try to assert some presence in front of Hannah Ramadan, because as she gets more confident, the Egyptian girl, she's going to start really going short. She knows that the movement of Rachel Chadwick is not quite there. Physically, very tough match last night. Her lengthened line as well has just dropped off Rachel Chadwick. She's not hitting with that conviction to the back of the court.
Slightly moving.
Yeah, she's not going to let ball there. Absolutely no chance. Nowhere near that.
6-2. You were wrong-footed, and the ball was on the right side. 6-2.
Pretty good.
What do you think, Joey? Hannah Ramadan, she's looking a really good prospect. She's going to get up there soon.
8-2. Down. 9-2.
Well, I mean, she's one of an army, isn't it? It's an army of these younger Egyptians, and the men's and women's keep saying it. It's so competitive out there in Egypt. And they seem to have absolutely no issues with playing these professional events. I mean, there's no real sign of nerves at all from Ramadan. She's just cracking on. 8 game balls for a 2-love lead.
Nice sort of consolation shot, really, in this game, as far as Chadwick's concerned. Just to make it look, I think, a little bit more respectable, really, because I can't see her winning this game.
Another one. Chadwick. Stroke to Chadwick. 4-10, gamble.
Chasing it, though, that's one thing for sure. She, as we saw yesterday, Chadwick, she keeps pushing hard, fighting with some good northern grit, I have to say. Play from Ramadan. She takes the second game, 11-4.
Ramadan leads 2 games to love.
Yeah, unrelenting Ramadan now, pushing on, 7 minutes second game. 2 games to love in this final.
Yeah, with the steam train kept going, really. Hannah Ramadan, she's unbelievably confident for 18 years of age. Hit the ball so well in this final, really fantastic timing. Rachel Chadwick pushing hard, clearly not at her best today, not able to move as she would like, but she's still pushing hard, playing some decent shots here and there, but Ramadan just will not stop. She's so attacking and aggressive. She leads 2-0.
So here we have the tournaments coming up for you, not on Squash TV. The Macau Open in China, you've got Marwan El-Shabagi topping that draw. For the men, the women is also very, very high with Joelle King and Annie Au. Nash Cup in Canada, that will be streamed from the club, incidentally, but not on Squash TV, sadly. And we've got the Otters International in Mumbai, so a nice spread through China, Canada, India, men's and women's, the last three, and then the women's in Brooklyn, New York, with El Shabini topping that draw, world number one, 20th to the 24th. So just looking at the scheduling there, Parky, I mean, we've got those four events, four of those are women, three are men, so it's growing all the time for the women.
Love all.
Yeah, it certainly is looking positive for the future.
This is John Chadwick. Yes, let love all.
I think there need to probably be a few more of the smaller events, though, for the women, just to try and build in the girls that are ranked lower down. They need to start to get experience and going up the rankings. I think when you start having
and out one love
of the World Series events, you know, the pinnacle, which is great, but that only serves a certain amount of players. And as the women's tour grows, they definitely need those building blocks for smaller tournaments to come through. And this is kind of one of them. This is a 5K. It's the level's been very, very good. I mean, see Ramadan, the way she's played
love
today and yesterday, and also the Battle of the English Girls last night, which was fantastic. So, you know, it's a real building of getting those smaller events, medium events, and then the World Series events.
Yeah, absolutely, and I think more internationally as well, all around the world, to give women all around the world, young players, a chance in Australia or South America or wherever it may be, not just in Europe.
And out, 3-1.
Well, this is a good start from Chadwick. She looks a little bit more positive out there. I'm not sure if she had anyone in her corner or if she's been receiving phone calls or texts. I did see Karim Al-Fati go off with Ramadan and her father. So she's got some good help in her corner.
Brilliant play. This is awesome from Chadwick. She's really giving it some.
Ball on the front wall. Ball was good.
That was fine. She hit that nicely hard enough.
Ball was good.
Snap to a swing. So she's got the bit between the teeth here, Chadwick.
5-1.
Oh wow, she's a completely different person. And now Ramadan's looking at her coaching corner, which is consisting, I think, of her father. And you saw Karim Al-Fati going off. So when she starts to look out the court, it's a good sign. This is completely different. I mean, she's like a different player. It's like somebody's replaced Rachel Chadwick.
7-1. Right
maybe
side,
she's had please a hairdryer chat on the phone from Phil Whitlock and really puts her into gear because this, as you say, is a different player. Really positive now. That boast isn't going to work though.
But I like the way she's using the lob again, just lifting it out. Wasn't brilliant there, but it's the right shot to play because
get the ball up in the air there. Ramadan's one that's not going to cause a huge amount of problems. Eight, and there's the unforced error, so this is brilliant. The crowd will love this as well. I think she gets this third game, Rachel Chadwick. The crowd will go bonkers. I want to see her battle in this women's match. That's more like it.
That's a great kill.
9-1.
If I was playing Ramadan, I would put everything on for a while inside. On the backhand in the back corner.
Yeah.
Just, I mean,
just
even
keep caning it.
A few rallies, yeah. Yeah, just to see. Just to really frustrate her.
Yeah. So lucky.
And so
still momentum with Rachel Chadwick.
9.
That's a good play from Ramadan there, just to try and get the point back and get some momentum in this game. That'll
decision
be a stroke.
Chadwick. Stroke to Chadwick. And out. 10.
So Rachel Chadwick with 8 game balls, sorry. And she's done it. Completely different
11.
Person. The aggressive twin of Rachel Chadwick has turned up.
Ramadan leads 2-1.
And this is what we're talking about. A bit of fiery northern passion there. You know, she's a young, well-trained lady, so she should be backing up after the semi-final last night. She is just 5 minutes to blow away Anna Ramadan, but the Egyptian still leads by 2-1.
Well, that was a very fiery third game from Rachel Chadwick, and it's what we wanted to see. It was a great effort, really. Just a bit of G'ing herself up, really. And, I mean, when you're 2 live down in the final of an event, you've got nothing to lose. You've got to really just like, try and pick yourself up and leave everything on the court. And she certainly did that in this third. She's given herself a bit of a chance now, really. She's taken the third game. It's 2-1 to Anna Ramadan.
Ramadan leads 2-1. Chadwick to serve. Love all.
Well, psychologically, that was very good of Chadwick. She got straight back on that court before Hannah Ramadan and was knocking the ball up, ready to crack on with the fourth game.
Yeah, that was a very good tactic. That was slightly lucky, raise of the hand.
One love.
It's an apology from Chadwick. I don't think she'll feel too apologetic.
No, that's something genuinely. You never apologise for anything.
Never hit any lucky shots.
Hard-nosed man from Rutland.
You were always hitting lucky shots, and there's no point in you putting your hand up, was there really?
There's a bit of time. Any consequences.
Out.
For squeeze, that's an example. Using the height, getting some decent airtime there. It was a nice lob, but then she just got an unforced error from Hannah Ramadan, who likes all the ball coming onto a racket quite quickly. So varying out the height and asking a bit of a question from that, because Hannah Ramadan's basically, when she goes short, she expects it to pretty much nearly be the end of the rally. So the neutralising of the lob is obviously a fantastic weapon anyway, but she's really starting to think about it, Chadwick.
Down.
A bit sloppy.
And out.
To be ultra critical, that was sloppy. Not what she would want. She's got to keep a dampening on the confidence of this young Egyptian girl. That's good hitting. Thank you. Backhand, back corner, Parshi.
An error.
Unforced error. She's looking out to her coach again.
Three.
Karima Anifati.
She really shouldn't have made an error here either. I mean, it was quite easy to get that out, but that's where the error's coming from. It's, she's thinking about what she's doing, Chadwick.
And out. 2-3.
What Rachel Chadwick has done really well here is kind of halt the steam train. She has actually really got into this match, and she started to play straight Ramadan.
Down.
There's a silly shot selection. It's a bit ambitious there. The ball was dropping all the time because of the pace, and that was only going to create one issue if you're that upright into the tin. Oh, that was a bit lucky, you know. It's, they all count. She and needs a bit of help. She was last couple of rallies, just slightly on the back foot.
Good wrong footer there from Hannah Ramadan.
5-4.
Behind Rachel Chadwick, and it was very difficult for her to react. That's a great shot. Great shot coming down on the ball nicely.
5-all.
Yeah, very deceptive on the forehand side for the lefty.
Get the width.
And out. 6-5. Down. 7-5.
Just feeling the physical effects a little bit, Parky, with everything last 2 days. What do you think?
I think so. So she's definitely started the last period. She's been moving a lot better.
Yes, let 7-5.
But obviously she's a bit weary, but she's pushing hard. She is gutsy. Still only 2 points in it here.
Down.
That's very tight cross court.
8-5.
So again, the steam train from Alexandria. Hannah Ramadan, that looked
stop.
Wow.
I can't believe that.
Wow.
That was a comparable.
And out, 6-8. Okay.
She's appealing
uphill
it.
On the serve.
I think that was down. I mean, it looked pretty dodgy to me.
Your serve was down.
I mean, yeah. Parky, that must take you back to that time when Paul Johnson said, you know, when you served it into the tin. Well, that looked up, actually.
That was in the queue of the squash, I think. Above the line.
That was actually...
Decision, Ramadan. No let.
Goodness gracious.
7-8.
It's not really going Ramadan's way, is it?
The last two rallies.
Far away from the ball. And you go to the player, not to the ball. 7-8.
Goodness me. So Rachel Chadwick has been given a lifeline here, Parky.
She certainly is. She certainly has, sorry. And she's the kind of player that you don't want to do that to, because she just keeps sticking down. In. That is a very, very poor error at this stage of the match.
Out.
Very poor.
9-7.
Was a big miss. Trouble. Oh, it's well straightened.
And there's a yellow from Anna Ramadan.
10-7, so with that championship fist pump, ball.
Ramadan with three championship balls here in Nantes.
Decision Chadwick, Yaslet, 10-7, championship ball.
That corner again, Parshik.
And out, 8-10, championship ball.
She might do if Chadwick plays a poor serve, which that was. Elected to leave it. Again, good length into that back left. Ah, that's a good shot.
Ah, superb rally from Rachel Chadwick. She's got to serve well here. Now, still championship ball with Ramadan.
Championship ball.
Good serve.
Oh, that's such an unfortunate. It was a decent serve and a wonderful length. So Hannah Ramadan holds on to win here in Nantes in the $5,000 ladies event. 18 years of age. Very gutsy performance, though, from Rachel Chadwick. She's had a superb tournament, really, the number six seed from the north of England. 35 minutes in the end, and it's Hannah Ramadan that gets past Rachel Chadwick, 12-10, 11-4, 2-11, 11-9. Let's hear from the champion of this ladies' event, Hannah Ramadan.
Vous pouvez faire notre petite interview en français. Ça lui permet de respirer un petit peu en même temps. C'est très bien. Mais nous avons les caméras de Squash TV, donc nous allons faire notre interview en français, en anglais et français traduit. Voilà. Merci pour ceux qui suivent Antoine. Well, what are your feelings now when you played a consistent match and? I mean, were you afraid when she came back in the third and in the end, this game?
As you can see, the pressure was, there's a lot of pressure on me. And that shows in the third game when I lost 11-2, I guess, which was really disappointing for me to lose my concentration. But I managed to win the game, the match, which is good.
Bravo à elle. Elle était sous pression, comme elle vous l'a dit, hein. Elle était sous pression, elle a réussi à tenir et à se défaire de cette joueuse qu'elle redoutait un petit peu. Il fallait de la concentration, elle s'en est sortie. Well, see you soon. Some words again for this atmosphere en français.
Merci à tout le monde pour avoir venu aujourd'hui. C'est l'ambiance extraordinaire ici. J'espère de vous revoir l'année prochaine. Merci à tout le monde. Merci beaucoup.
Yes!
Hannah Ramadan really pushing through and Rachel Chadwick just not quite able to stop the steam train. Egyptian steam train in this final. Wonderful performance all the way through this tournament, Hannah Ramadan. And Chadwick, towards the end, just got a glimmer of hope. I thought she might just take it to fifth game. But I think just slight weariness, she was trying to force her mind to believe that she wasn't. But Hannah Ramadan takes it in four.
So that wraps it up for the women's. What a result there for the young Egyptian. Now we have the men's match, which is England France.